video we'll be doing elbow flexion range of motion. Patient is supine with their forearm in full supination, a towel under the humerus, and in 0 degrees of flexion. You are using the lateral epicondyle of the humerus as your fulcrum, the lateral midline of the humerus as your proximal arm using the acromion process as reference, and the distal arm is the lateral midline of the radius. So to start, you can ask the patient to actively move into elbow flexion. Get your measurement, and you can always use some passive motion to try to gain any extra degrees of loosey restriction. Normal range of motion is 140 to 150 degrees, and there should be a soft end heel. This video is for elbow extension range of motion. Patient is supine, forearm in full supination, towel under the humerus. And you're doing this so that if the patient has any hyperextension, you're able to measure that as well. Same as elbow flexion, your fulcrum is the lateral epicondyle of the humerus. Proximal arm is the lateral midline of the humerus, referencing the acromion process. And the distal arm is the lateral midline of the radius. So again, there shouldn't be much active movement. You can just ask them to straighten their arm against the towel. Normal range of motion is zero, but again, some patients may have hyperextension, and you can document that as well. This should be a hard end heel,